active listening, and our Toastmasters, Elaine, I want to invite her to continue the evening.
Good evening, fellow Toastmasters, and welcome to the 90th. We're almost at 100. I think we'll reach 100 maybe by March. I'll give you a few things over the course of the evening. With each point, I will also give you three idioms. So you need to be listening for the idioms that will be part of the communication. And in addition, those idioms are there in order to help us be more engaged in that principle of active listening. Active, not passive. Now I'm looking around thinking to myself, one of the first things about active listening is body language. And I'm looking, thinking, okay, what would it look like if everyone really wanted to hear what we had to say, right? What do you do when you really want to hear what someone has to say? You move up, you get on the edge of your seat, you put your arms down to focus a little more. Body language is such an important part. Body language speaks volumes about how much you want to hear what the speaker has to say. But before I go on to the active listening, we'd like to welcome guests, and we'll introduce you a little bit later. But first, we'd like to give our different individuals an opportunity to explain what their roles are this evening, and who the individual is doing that role. So our first role is our table topics master. So, Tolga, can you tell us a little bit about that role?
Good evening, everybody. I am Tolga. I am tonight's table topic master. I will give the opportunity to those who are not assigned for a speaking role. And these people are expected to give impromptu speeches, and which means basically without any preparation, and this speech is expected to last minimum 1 minute, maximum 2.5 minutes. Thank you.
Thank you. Our word master for the evening is Mustafa, and we'll see if you can pinpoint what his word is for the evening.
Good evening, everyone. My role is tonight is word master. As I'm not a good listener, as I told you before, if you use this word written here, there, and there, if you try to use and don't hesitate to use, if you try to use, I'll count on and I will report the people in your speech or in table topic session, how many times you used. Thank you very much.
Our vote counter for the evening is Gizem.
Good evening, everyone. Tonight I'm going to collect our ballots, and then I will announce the best prepared speaker, best table topic master, and best evaluator. Thank you. I will be the timer tonight. We all have a time limit. We are not allowed to talk for all evening. And each speaker has a time limit, as I said. For example, an icebreaker has to speak minimum 4 minutes to 6 minutes, maximum 6.5 minutes. I have a clock, and I will tell you, I will show my cards to you, you are within time limits or not. If I show the green card, you are okay, you are within the time limit, but if I show you the red one, you are not. Thank you.
Okay, the red one actually will tell them that they ended their time, like you said, but then they'll have about 30 seconds after that to finish up their speech and still be able to be within the time.
How about the yellow one?
The yellow one tells them that you have you're just about to finish. Like between 5 and 7 minutes, then at 6 minutes, she puts up the yellow one so everybody knows that I have only 1 more minute to finish my toss. So a little bit of a warning sign. Thank you. Our grammarian for the evening is Noemi.
Good evening, Jonathan Spencer said yes, because English is not except for few native speakers. English is not our first language, it's our second or third or fourth. So when we speak, we have some blemishes, and I'm going to pinpoint the misuse of the English language. I will not pinpoint those who misuse it, but I will pinpoint those who
All right, our odd counter for the evening is Yaku.
Okay. Yeah, that's right. I am the odd counter for the evening, and I will just get you well these things, and I will count it, and at the end I will give the result of it.
Thank you. Our general evaluator for the evening is
my role is to evaluate the meeting in general. I will call for the meeting for reports for grammarian, wordmaster, counter for their reports, and I will call the speeches evaluators.
I will be the table topics evaluator tonight. My role will be listening to this session carefully and evaluating the session, basically the impromptu speakers.
Thank you. And last, our listener for the evening, Rob
Kelly. Dear Toastmasters and guests, it's good to be with you. I'll be your the one that's asking questions about the talks. We have 4 speakers, and I'll try to have 2 questions per talk. And my questions will try to pinpoint the main parts of their talk. So thank you.
Thank you. Again, active listening is a foundation of communication. If we can't listen, then in actuality, we're not really communicating. And body language is such an important part of active communication. It is said that actually 85% of communication is nonverbal communication. It can be your facial expressions, it can be the way you move towards someone, but 85% is nonverbal. That's why, as a foreigner in a different country, I would have the ability to ask a person where the closest store is without being able to communicate verbally, because 85% of communication is nonverbal. And body language is a large part of that nonverbal communication. Again, in active listening, one of the most important things is that we listen with our bodies as well as with our ears. In a sense, you want your body to say to the other person, I'm all ears. I really want to hear what you have to say. You want to lean forward to let them see that you're interested in what they're communicating. Because when we listen well, people feel heard. And when we don't listen well, people don't feel heard. So listening is sometimes even more than 50% of the communication. All right, what we're going to have next are our speakers for the evening. The first speaker we have is Sinem. And Sinem will be giving her icebreaker speech. Ralph will be her evaluator. So Ralph, can you tell us what we're looking for? For Sinem's speech.
Yes, first, this is Sinem's icebreaker. So we want to hear about you mainly, and that's the uniqueness of an icebreaker talk. The main thing we want to hear is, we want to feel at the end that we've gotten to know you. We want to, hopefully you give a good introduction about, you know, where, you know, beginning years of your life, things you've done, a middle part, tell us different parts about yourself, and then with a conclusion about yourself. But so we look forward to hearing
from you. Thank you.
The biggest trouble in my life, and those who are not Turkish probably won't understand what does it mean. And it means that in Turkish, horseman, rider, jockey is unfortunately, and therefore I was always under some jokes from my friends, and I always have to convince my friends to stop bantering, and but they never gave up. And then I decided to do something different way and convince myself constantly. One, always spread your last name, and always enjoy when they try to joke. And made up a story with your grandpa was a real jockey, and with humming with this small song, riders on the horse. It's so funny, but the exact thing I did. Then I realized that they didn't enjoy as before, and they reduced their sense of humor, because when they tried to joke, I always having much more than having fun. And it was my first try and succeed. And Barney Stinson was right, new is always better. And as you guess, I was born as a member of Y generation in Aydın. And we are so adaptive, so technological, and so impatient. We get bored sometime, someone or something easily, and we want to be able to change everything at the moment that we want. Sometimes we could, sometimes couldn't, but waiting for a while in order to our dreams, targets, imagines turn into be real is quite difficult. And the best goal for us is the one that quickest. And I was only in a primary school. I have already studied in Bal. This is the high school in Izmir. And according to me, it was the best in Izmir and one of the best in Turkey. Maybe who are in Turkish already know the Borno Anatolian High School. And I'm a real Izmir lover, and I can define the Izmir only one sentence. There is no problem that cannot be solved with a beer and muscles in cordon. I hope I will back there one day. And as Gemay, we always wonder, we have a deep passion to experience new adventures. And I just started some series of challenges for upcoming year or years for myself. Read 52 books and watch 52 films in 2017. And lose 10 kilos in 5 months. And travel at least 10 different countries in 10 years. I was Vienna and Budapest last week, and I'm really happy for my first success. I believe that world is a big place to explore. We just need to beat ourselves and always try to something different way. You will find your best, because new is always better. Thank you.
Izmir, the place where a beer and muscles solve anything. I think we all want to go to Izmir now, don't we? Thank you very much. Our second speaker for the evening is
Anvat Volkan-Dolfan. I will go first.
Speaking first, yeah. Speaking first. And then we can collect them all.
Yes,
at the end of that. Gizem will, before you come up here, though, Gizem, I'm going to have your evaluator. Benjamin, can you tell us a little bit of what we're looking for? Gizem will be doing her second speech.
Yes, this will be Gizem's second speech. And the main point of the second speech is to organize your speech. It's to have a good intro, body, and conclusion, to have everything supporting the main purpose, the main point of the speech. So let's pay attention to Gizem and see if it's well organized and all shaped around one big idea. So look forward to hearing from you again, Gizem.
I appreciate to be here to this meeting. Then I want to start with myself, because I did my icebreaker speech at 72 Toastmaster, and now we are 90, so it was a long time. Maybe some of you don't know me. I'm Gizem. I'm 22 years old, and I graduated from Edirne University last year. Then now I'm a dietitian. So I prepared my presentation about nutrition and healthy life. But before the presentation, I have good news. I got a job 2 days ago. I started. Wow. And now I have a really incredible story to get this job, because I didn't expect that they get me, or I was confused actually. Last June, I graduated and I applied some jobs, but I went to interviews. It was really too stressful times, because I was really too excited, and they just gave me too less money and they want to work a lot. I told them this is too much working time, this is too less for me. Then I just came back to Denizli to take a break. Then when I came back to Istanbul, I decided to what I want really, because it's important thing to be happy at job, and I will spend my 8 hours in a day at job. It should be perfect for me. Then I thought, last year I had lots of internships, and one of them is Beşiktaş Municipality. So I thought that maybe Asian side doesn't have any dietitian at municipality. So I applied for I went to Ataşehir Municipality. Then I asked them, do you have any dietitian? They told me, no, we don't have, and we don't want any dietitian. We don't have it for maybe 2 years. Then I said, okay, I want to write a petition. You need to take, because many graduated dietitians are here. You need to hire someone for diet. Then I went to there every week, every each of week until now. Then they accepted me. Okay, yes, you can start it here. you want it a lot. Then I hired. Okay, and now I'm a dietitian of Ataşehir Municipality and at Türkan Saylan Medicine Center. Yes. If you want to visit me, I'm looking forward to seeing you there. And now, my presentation. Nutrition and healthy life. I think many people think that they know how to eat, they know how to feed themselves, but correct one is just need to go to dietitians always know how to feed perfectly. So, for example, it doesn't matter you have any disease, you don't need to obese or cancer or any disease. You just need to go to dietitian and he or she can tell you body fat composition, then you can understand I'm healthy or I'm not healthy. So this is healthy eating means consuming the right portion, the right quantities of food and all food groups. For example, in your plate, I'm sorry about this. I'm putting it for. Eating well along with you can be active and with healthy life. You can. Next time. It doesn't matter.
Right.
For example, we wake up on the morning and we slept at night. We really didn't eat many long time. Because of that, breakfast is important to start with today. If you tell yourself, I don't have time, really you don't have time. But if you believe yourself, I will be great if I have a breakfast. So you thought this, then you can do breakfast. You just need to change your habits to be healthy. Then, with being healthy, you can give you more energy to your body. Then you can be more energetic, more active. It's better. And being healthy, prevent your future disease. For example, diabetes. If you eat too fatty things, you can be have fear. Then you can feel too bad. This is food plate. For example, in a day you need to eat fruit, all should be balanced. Fruit, vegetables, meat, fish, foods, meat and dairy foods, and bread, also carbohydrate too. This is our food pyramid. For example, triangle was fat. You can see that this is too unhealthy for you, and you need to balance fats, oils, and sweets. It's important thing. You just need to consume it, but not too much. Everything you can consume, but just know the how much you can consume it. And you need to limit sugar and salt. It's important. And set yourself up for success. Moderation is the key. And for example, add calcium for strong bone. Good protein in perspective. Then I also put the water air one of it, of course. Just the water I'm doing. It's a bit more. Oh, my goodness. Minimum 2 liters. Water you need to drink. Then these are phosphates. Everyone knows something too long. It's hard to eat 5 portions of fruit and vegetables every day. If false, yes, you can eat. If you have time to eat fruit and vegetables, your Chinese. Bread and potatoes must be cut out of your deck. It's always hot. You need to carbohydrate on your plate, and you need to eat this also. Then a high protein diet helps weight loss. Always a sportsman or woman think this, but also protein need to be balanced also. If you eat 10 meatballs in a day, it's too harmful for you. But 5 is okay, maybe. It depends on your. And keep calm and trust the dietitian.
I think for Gizem, there must have been an active listener inside the attaché here. Municipality thinking,
yeah.
Okay, maybe she's right. Maybe we need a dietitian here.
Yes.
So, I'm sure they will not regret having hired you as a
dietitian. Yeah, thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Our third speaker for today is Elgin. And so we have Ozan will be evaluating Elgin. Can you give us a little idea?
Okay.
What we should be looking for.
Elgin will do in her third speech today. In the aim in the third speech is important. Oh, sorry, fourth speech is important. How to say something. For example, you can say something in a way, but if you say in a good way, it can give you a message, and also it can give you good understanding. So we will see today in her speech, you can also pay attention, how she say the things. Also, she can use less words, using the long sentences, and she will also use and more understandable, and for us is easily to follow the speech.
Thank you.
And good luck.
Welcome out. Hi everyone. Today my speech is about teaching. Before I share my experience with teaching, I would like to talk before and after teaching. We are living in Istanbul for me. Istanbul is a very stressful city. There is a heavy traffic outside. If you are working, it is not easy to handle the business stress. If you read daily newspapers, it is rare to read something nice on the newspapers. For stress management, I attended yoga class in the past. Then after yoga, I attended a belly dance class. Both teachers were very ambitious, so for stress management, they were unsuccessful for me. And then I met with teacher. Can I ask anyone heard the word teacher before?
Yeah.
Did you perform teacher?
No. Man of Tahiti, Keanu Reeves, the movie.
I know that they live in China and watch them a lot. Many years ago, I think I was 11, I had been to Hong Kong. I woke up early in the morning and I saw a lot of people outside performing something very slowly. I didn't know what they were performing, and that was the first time I heard the word teacher. Years later, I met with a girl in Turkey. She was performing teacher alone. She told me that she beat epilepsy and she boosted self-confidence with the help of Aikido and Taichi. And she told me also that she overcame her fears. I was affected by her story. Nowadays, I am attending a beginner class in Taichi. It is called Nine Forms. It looks very simple, the movements, but They are very detailed, as you learn step by step from a master. This is a Tai Chi movie from YouTube. You can easily find the. He is a Tai Chi master. His name is Yu Yong or Li Yong. He is my teacher's master. Tai Chi is a Chinese martial art. It has an interesting story. We know that there is a Shaolin temple in China. It is a Buddhist temple. And around 400 years, this temple built at the peak of a mountain. In the beginning, the monks were not performing the martial art training. The purpose of this temple was to preach and to pray. Then a monk, I should look at the name of the monk, called Bodhidharma, arrived at the temple and saw the monks in a very poor physical condition. And he was very distressed for their poor physical condition. And he started to train them to improve their physical condition. And this led to the creation of Kung Fu, Shaolin Kung Fu. And Kung Fu and the Tai Chi are very close to each other. Nowadays, once a week, I'm attending this Tai Chi class. It is 9 forms. It looks very easy, but in detail. I would like to show you the forms. It has a very nice music. Before performing the 9 forms for 10 minutes, you should do 10 minutes relaxation exercise. He does very slowly. You have to be very patient, but at the end, you feel very relaxed and relieved and happy. It is how I experience with the Tai Chi. I hope you do practice Tai Chi once in your life and experience this feeling also. Thank you listening to me patiently.
Thank you. Don't think I can quite duplicate that. However, it is known that Tai Chi can really help people relax, as she pinpointed in that situation. Can you take a minute or so to write your comments for Elchen and let us hear from the timer, how did everyone do with their times?
Sina, the first speaker, did well, 4.41 minutes. Gizem, 8.10 minutes.
Okay, she can go all the way to 7.5, but after 7.5 is not able to qualify for the competition, but still did a great job. And?
Alchin is 4.54. But it should be minimum
5.
Only 6.
Okay, thank you. Therefore, we do have a winner for the evening. Congratulations. Perhaps that's just an approval for you.
You don't
that
need to vote.
You do not need to vote, but I will give you a minute to make comments.
Please vote.
Üçüncü de alırsın. Bizi ne sana verir? Ya valla seni yanlış.
Çıkıyorum şuraya.
Ben fark ettim biliyor musun? Öyle bir şey yok yani. Bunu yapmadı. Thank you.
you can pass them on down to the exam. We'd now like to, it's not every week that we have an opportunity to have an instructional speaker, but this evening we have Noemi, who will be giving us instruction on what it means to be a really good evaluator. So welcome, Noemi.
Member of the club in Manila, and they've been a club for 20 years, and I've been a member of the club off and on, and they have great members, great evaluators, very keen evaluators, but guess what, there was a time when this great evaluator overdid it, and guess what happened, the member did not come back. She was so hurt by the evaluation. It was very good, but it was hurt. But she was hurt. So, right off, let me tell you that the art of evaluation involves the KKK, and it means kiss, kick, and kiss. So when you do evaluation, you always start with a kiss. Something positive that you like, except that person's heart, very well with what you're saying, and then you can kick. Nicely. You can point out the things in his or her life that she needs to improve on, and then you end, not with a bad taste on the mouth, but with another kiss. But overall, you did so well, and I specifically like this. Okay, so that's the art of evaluation in a nutshell. But let me point out to you some nitty-gritty. So, in the next few minutes, this is an overview of what I am going to share with you. First, I will share with you the three roles of an evaluator, the behavior of an effective evaluator, and essential skill of an evaluator, and evaluate to motivate. So first, the three roles of an evaluator. An evaluator is, first of all, a motivator, facilitator, and a counselor. What does this mean? First, motivator. Motivator because he fuels the speaker's desire for improvement. So you're saying that you're a good speaker. You just need to improve in this area and you will be even better. So if you hear that, wouldn't you want to improve? Oh, I just need to improve this. So you are motivated. This is you don't like feel like, oh my goodness, you said 10-20 things that I need to improve, you know, just like this one small thing, you need to like tweak it a little bit and you will be fine. So you motivate the speaker to improve. Motivate. Next is facilitator. You show the speaker how to improve. You just don't say, I didn't hear any vocal variety in your speech. You say, vocal variety, you can make it loud. You can pause a little. Or you say, you need to make your gesture bigger because your audience is big. So you demonstrate how the person can improve. And as a counselor, you help the speaker overcome his fear of public speaking. You've always heard this. They said there are two things that people fear. One is death, and the second is public speaking. There is a bridge. There is a bridge from fear to
death.
Confidence. A bridge between fear and confidence in speaking. And you need to help the speaker to find or build that bridge as a counselor. So what are your behavior of an effective evaluator? One is you show that you care. So in our club, we are not here to put people down. We are colleagues, we are not competitors. So you show that you care. You can even say, have you given your next speech? Can I help you? Even if it's still a draft, you want me to go over your draft and maybe point out some things. You can also, too, suit this evaluation to the speaker. Get to know the person, because some people are sensitive, so you cannot be too direct. If it's for it, you can be direct. You can mind. You know, he wants you to tell it how it is. But if a person is sensitive, you might put a little break. Three is know the speaker's objective.
if the speaker is in one or two, he only knows organize your speech. So do not evaluate and say, I don't like your vocal variety, don't have vocal variety, because the person doesn't know that. So know the objectives and evaluate according to the objectives. Do not evaluate on a higher project. Listen attentively. How do you listen attentively? Like what you're doing now, I'm so impressed, you're taking notes, it's wonderful. So you can listen attentively and show that you listen attentively by quoting. You can say, you know, I like the way you said these words. It is very appropriate. It struck me right here at the heart. I love it. And personalizes his language, the speaker's language. So all evaluations are subjective. It's not like hard, fast rules. So you say, in my opinion, Elchin, you did very well in this, but I was just thinking that maybe you can do it this way. So it's, and you talk to the person you're evaluating. It's not a canned evaluation. It's you want to say that you listen very well, and this is especially for you. I crafted this just for you. Gives positive reinforcement. In my club, when I was new, I didn't know that I could do public speaking. And I actually didn't even joke. People laughed and I was surprised. That was funny. And someone said, you know, you should put more joke in your speech. And actually, you can join our humorous speech contest. I could? Yes! So I was reinforced. Motivate the speaker. How do you motivate the speaker? Well, as I said, you need to get to know the speaker. And I think for us, when we hear positive things spoken to us, it is like a plant that you water, it grows. But if you say negative things, it wilts and dies. So positive things reinforces, and negative things kind of like wilt. So maybe put a lot of those of positive, and then one or two negative, because the person cannot actually handle 10 or 20 things that he or she needs to improve in his speech. Evaluate the behavior of the speaker, not the person. If you have a personal grudge with the speaker, don't say, I didn't really like the way you've been doing this, how you're treating me, you know. So just the speech, not the behavior, nourishes the speaker's self-esteem. Remember, especially with the guys, they need to be respected. So we need to do our evaluation with in mind that they are not disrespected. And lastly, show the speaker how to improve. I already said how this is done. Don't just say it's good, it's fine, but show specifically how it can be improved. And especially in terms of body language or gesture, I see a lot of people doing like this. And it's not nice. So usually the neutral position actually for a speaker is like this. It's very relaxed. You don't do like this. You don't do like this. This is a neutral position, and you don't actually pinpoint. You know, you do like this. Okay. This is better. So you demonstrate how it's done. So these are the behaviors and effective evaluator. The next one is the essential skill of an effective evaluator. One is that he develops an evaluation vocabulary, and you need to sharpen your ability to analyze. What does this mean? So, developing an evaluation vocabulary. To convey your feedback in a clear manner, you need to use words which accurately describe what you mean. Accurately. So when you say fine, it's not accurate. When you say good or nice, it's not accurate. Unless you say specifically why it is nice or good. So avoid words with broad meanings such as good, nice, fine. You can say like, I like the way you said it because it struck my heart. When you use this word, I really love it. I like it when you said that you didn't just say the room was crowded, you say that we were packed. It was a room for 20 people and we were 50. So I like the way you use a word language. picture language. So you have to be very specific. You can use superlative when a speaker did an excellent job, but you use excellent words very sparingly. Because if you, especially for someone who's new, you say you did an excellent job, then there's no need for them to join our club because they're already excellent. So you use this sparingly, use it when it's only well deserved, and I use it actually as an evaluator. You always need to find something that the person can improve on, even if the person is already a veteran speaker. The reason why the person is speaking is he needs to find an area to improve on. So sharpening your ability to analyze. Evaluating a speech involves careful analysis. And there are three items to consider. One is structure. What is the structure? It's just basically outline. What outline did the person use? What is, did he do a prep, position, reason, example, position? Did he do PPF, past, present, future? Or did he do an SMG, story message game? So outline. Was there an introduction? Did he explain to us what the speech is gonna be? Was there points? Are the points supported? Was there a summary? Was there a memorable conclusion? So this is a structure of the speech. So you evaluate that. And then also content. Why is content nice? Content is nice if there is research, there is quotation, so-and-so said, or according to the findings of so-and-so, the content is meaty. It's not just like hearsay. And the examples are appropriate. And lastly, delivery. Delivery involves facial expression, body language, vocal variety, things like that. So this is pitch, these are delivery. So remember, S, C, D, structure, content, and delivery. Evaluate to motivate. The word motivate comes from the Latin movere, which means to move. We translate our initial reaction of the speech into motivational feedback. How did the speech affect you? You tell us whether positive or negative. How do you know that you are a successful evaluator? The speaker wants to speak again, and those who listen say, I want to join this club. I want to improve the way they improve other people. Good evening.
Yeah. Thank you. We'll go very shortly to our break, but before we do, so I mentioned first, body language is important in listening as much as it is in speaking. There's another thing that is really important in listening, and that is, I know you're on the edge of your seat waiting for this, but we must have no preconceived notions. When we're listening to someone else, we need to go into that situation not thinking that we're reading their mind, but really listening to what they say, because I cannot read their mind, right? And so when you're talking with them, many times they might be beating around the bush about something, not sure exactly how to express it to you, but the more you sit and listen, the more they're able to communicate. So even if in the end they're beating a dead horse, telling you the same thing again and again, if you continue to listen, you'll be able to help them pinpoint exactly what the need is and why they are wanting to talk with you in the first place. Right before we go to our break, we do have a few guests. We'd like to just introduce them quickly, if that's all right.
This is my music instructor, Ilan Tüysak. I talked about the before meeting. Oh. Before, yeah. I'm a member of the Turkish traditional music chorus, but he's making a universal music. He's playing many of his moves. Okay.
Dr. Human.
Hi, my name is Valjean. It's my first time here in Toastmasters Asia. I've been in European once. So the reason that I wanted to join the club is because I want to improve my public speaking skills. That's the reason I'm here.
For better speaking. Welcome. Yeah. Nice to have you today.
Hi, I'm Kubra. I'm here thanks to Gizem. I'm sorry for my English. I'm here because I want to improve my speaking skills. I think it's helpful for my job. So I'm here and it's good to be here. Thanks for all.
Welcome.
Welcome, Gizem. Hi. I think we have one more guest. Hi, hello there. My name is Lev. Russian, but according to translations to English of Lev Tolstoy, it is Leo, so that's her name. I am here because as somebody who thinks I can be like a future leader, I should work a lot on my public speaking skills and brush up on that a lot. So hopefully I could find what I need here.
Yeah. Okay. Right, if you don't mind, we could keep the break so that we are back in by quarter till.
Yeah.
And then help yourself to